Hello everyone, I'm Magnus Carlsen from Norway, chess world champion since 2013. I'm going to break down a couple of games from the Queen's Gambit series, so please enjoy. The one that was most aesthetically pleasing for me, even though in a way it was very, very simple, it was the one from the Kentucky State Championship from 1963. Basically here, he's one move away from a draw, which considering everything that happened would be an enormous achievement for him. And he carelessly decides to take her last pawn. And indeed, what could be more natural, right? She has a rook and a knight and a king against a rook and three pawns. And experienced chess players, they will know that against good defense, you cannot win with a rook and a knight against just a rook. Even if he loses all his pawns, he should be able to make a draw after he's grabbed that last pawn. However, he's been careless. He's overlooked the fact that these pawns, they're all in the way. And they're taking away squares from his rook. And simply by attacking the rook with the king, as she does, not once, but twice, she attacks the rook. The rook has to move one square away, and then she attacks it with the king again. And at this point, the rook has so many squares. It has practically a full board to choose from. But wherever the rook goes, it's either going to be forked by the knight or captured by the king or the rook or the knight. Then he, with a smile, she realizes that his rook is trapped. And then for some reason, he doesn't realize it as well. It moves the rook away, and he gets forked, and he loses. Really pretty segment there. It's a game segment that I'd never seen before, and it's a theme that you so rarely see, and to me was so beautiful in its simplicity, and it shows the kind of imagination that she had at a very early age, that this one I just found to be really, really lovely. I hope you guys enjoyed these little bits from Beth Harmon's games, and go out and play, have fun.